Hello, so today I'm starting an entirely new section of videos about a topic I really don't know anything about, and I have no business making this video, but I'm going to make an attempt, and you, the internet, will, I don't know why I'm pointing in a like aggressive manner, I welcome you with a hug, but you, the internet, will hopefully leave comments and let me know what I've got wrong and what I'm missing here, because honestly, this is stuff which has been sort of new to me as well. So, and the topic is, it probably says it somewhere on this webpage that I'm sitting in, but HTML. HTML, what is that? CSS, what is that? DOM, what is that? How do you write JavaScript to control all this stuff and make magic happen on a web page? So there's a and all of this in the context of a JavaScript framework known as p5.js. So in this first video, all I want to talk about is HTML, and I want to open a p5 sketch. If you've been watching the previous videos, we've been writing code in this function, set up and draw, and making things happen on the screen, and making objects, and snow, and particle system, and rainbows, and all sorts of wonderful things. But now I want to take a step, peel back some layers, and say, what's actually happening before the JavaScript even executes? And what's happening is this thing known as HTML. So actually, there was you can't even see that, but that's okay. There was a moment in time in a previous video. Here I am. This is my list, by the way. I'm gonna make a whole bunch of these videos. There was a moment in time. I gotta close this screen, which has me on it. There was a moment in time in a previous video where I went to that settings icon and I clicked on the settings icon, and then I clicked on this show sidebar button, and we saw here. Look at that. There's this file called index.html. And if you recall, that camera shut off. Okay, stop everybody. Okay, back after a moment of technical difficulties. What I was referring to here is in this HTML file, this gobbledygook, there is this line that refers to the JavaScript file. The JavaScript file being in our world, in the world that we lived in previous to this video, this is all that existed, setup and draw. But the only reason setup runs and draw runs, there's two reasons. One reason is up here, that p5.js is a library that's referred to in a script tag, and sketch.js, which is our code, is referred to in a script tag. So this is actually the file that matters. This HTML file is the file that matters. What goes in that file? How does that file work? And what might you be able to do with that file to make certain things happen? So now, let me come back over here. This video is a disaster. Talk about HTML for a second. So HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It's a markup language, meaning, I don't know what that means. somebody write in the comments what that means. But the idea here is that it is based on this concept of a tag. So if you have some characters in between a less than and a greater than symbol, this is a tag. The HTML tag begins and it ends with a backslash HTML. So I have now created this body. I shouldn't use the word body because that's going to be something more specific in a moment. But I've created this area where I'm going to start to put some content all in between these tags. Now, some things that might exist here is, I don't know how to say, another tag, maybe a tag known as body. And inside that body, I might put some other things. I might put a tag with a P for paragraph. This is a paragraph. And I might put another tag, like above that, H1, which is a header, like title of page. Then I might put another tag, which is like image source equals apple.jpg. So there are all these things that can go in an HTML page. This is the markup, the source code, the behind the scenes information and structure behind what you will actually see on the page. This renders, that was a bad pen, this renders to, on the page, title of page, this is a paragraph, and then a picture of an apple, assuming I have that file. So the idea here is that you can create content and layout by this sort of system of nested tags. I have an HTML page in that page. There's a body in that body. There's, I wrote something wrong here. That close tag should be a header. There's a header, a paragraph, and an image. So one of the things that can go in here also is a canvas. And p5 inserts the canvas on that page, which the function create canvas. So there's this kind of question here. It's like, well, what is it? Why am I here? What is going on with my life? And what am I trying to do? If you just want to present some content that you want to type, you have an essay you wrote or a story you wrote, and it has a title and it has some pictures in it, and it's sort of like static or you might say flat, just sort of existing content, you can put that all into an HTML document, open that HTML content in a browser, and you will see it there. If you want this page to be interactive or dynamic, have behaviors, change over time, change when a user clicks, animate, whatever strange experimental thing you can think of, that's where you need JavaScript. So this, the purpose of my set of videos here is to look at, hopefully you know a little bit about JavaScript now, and you can program and make these little animations. What's the page behind that sort of hold? What is the page where that JavaScript is acting on? How do you put stuff in the page? How do you put stuff in the JavaScript, and how do those two things talk to each other? Okay, so here's some sort of basic idea of HTML. Now let's walk over slowly here over to this computer, and I'm going to do something crazy, which is I'm just going to say like, never mind you P5 editor and whatever HTML you made for me automatically. I'm going to take all of this out. And I'm going to close this preferences, and I'm going to say, I want to have a body, and I want to have a header. I am making a video, and I want to have a paragraph. This is my essay about how I love to make videos. They are my favorite. I'm just like lost in train of thought about it. I'm stream of consciousness. Favorite thing to do, rainbow, which is my thing that I always just use rainbows. Okay, so you can see I'm starting to just put content in this HTML page, and I'm going to run it. And look at this. It's like I wrote a program that made this, but I didn't. I just manually added some content to the HTML page. What P5 actually loads in this window, in this like little browser window, is the HTML file. And so you could say like, well, what's in the JavaScript file? Nothing. But I could add create canvas 200, and I could add background 0, fill 255 00. I'm also now lost in my train of thought of programming. Rectangle 00, 100, 100, 50, 50. I've got some JavaScript, I've got some HTML, and now let me run this again or load this page again, and we can see here, where is the canvas? It doesn't exist. So nothing actually happens on the page unless it's included in the HTML file. And when I wiped the HTML file that the editor made for me automatically, I took out all the references to that JavaScript file. So if I want to have both the HTML content and the JavaScript stuff happening at the same time, I need to have both of those things. But I'm going to do something a little weird. I'm just going to make a new project, and I'm going to look at its HTML file, and I'm going to grab this header area. So I'm going to grab this. Close that. So what's missing from this document, HTML body, is a head tag. And a head tag is where I might reference other files like JavaScript files and other things that you might see later on if I ever get to making some videos that make any sense. So I'm going to paste that back in here. You can see in this, you can see now this page both, and I'm going to take out this stuff here, some extra stuff. Now this page, and I'm not using these libraries. Well, I'll leave that there. Now you can see this page is referring to the P5 library, some other libraries that I'll mention in a second, our JavaScript code, and the HTML stuff that I added. And now if I run this or load this page again, you can see, look at this. We now have other content around the canvas. So this is the first step, right? How do you make content written into the HTML file? How do you use p5.js and JavaScript to make a canvas? How do both those things exist in the same p5.js project? And the next step is, what's the interplay between those two things? What if I want this header text to change when I click the mouse? What if I want the font to change when the rectangle moving across the canvas gets to the other side of the screen? These are the kinds of questions I hope to answer and make more clear in the next set of videos. There's a couple things that I missed here, so that I think are important before I finish. So one thing I want to mention about this, You know what? I could come back to this later, you know, because what I wanted to mention is how this is a tree structure, so I'll come back to it later, but now that I said it, I have to talk about it. So this is a tree structure, and this is something that's important to think about. The root node of this tree is HTML. Inside of HTML, there's a body. Right? Open tag, close tag. Inside of the body, there's a header, a paragraph, and an image.
Header, a paragraph, and an image.
You know, that paragraph could have things inside the paragraph. As we saw in the HTML file, there was actually a head tag, which included some scripts, JavaScript scripts, and other things. So this is an important also way of thinking. And I think nobody's been watching the ad. No, if you're still watching this video, let me know, because I don't know, I've been going on for a long time. But this, I think, is a clue to this idea of something known as the DOM, Document Object Model. This, I don't actually know what the DOM is, but I think I have an idea just by talking this through. This is a document. These are objects inside the document. The model is this tree structure of how a page is structured. There's an HTML element, an object inside of it. There's a body object inside of it. There's a H1 object, a paragraph object, an image object. This whole document has a model, a structure for how it's organized of objects. Document object model. And how do you manipulate that document? DOM manipulation means how to use JavaScript to manipulate this on the fly in real time. This is the subject I hope to continue to cover and make more and more examples of. Now, one thing I should admit here is this is like the most pathetic or like tiniest like explanation of HTML ever. Like, it looked at like a few things. So I'm really hoping to get to more about JavaScript and programming and manipulation in real time. If you're interested in HTML, anyway, anybody who knows something about HTML, write in the comments some links I might include. But I'll try to refer you to them other sources, like what are all the possible tags? How are these tags organized? How are they different? You know, what does it mean to have this source equals apple.jpg? This is an attribute. We'll get to some of these things as I get further along through these videos as well. So for you, if you're kind of following along in the sort of like watch a video, do a quick exercise, what I would say is see if you can make this happen. Take one of your P5 sketches and add some other stuff around it, around the page. We're going to be able to do a lot more with mixing it soon, but oh, this has only been about 10 minutes, this video. I feel like I've been talking for like 45 minutes. That I think will be a good start. And in the next video, I'm going to look at my list here. The next video, I'm going to look at making DOM elements, making HTML elements on the fly from JavaScript, adding them to the page, just like Create Canvas added one to the page. OK, I'm going to hit stop on recording and go on to the next video.